Hi, hello and welcome to Sizzling Vidya YouTube channel. Today I am going to review Prestige Induction Cooktop. An induction stove comes in really handy when you have guests or parties at home, when you have so many dishes to cook, or in case you have a sudden cut in your regular piped gas supply, or maybe if there is a delay in your LPG cylinder delivery. In case you are a bachelor or if you stay in a PG or a hostel, then also this induction stove will be of great use for you. So now let's get into the video.
This is the Prestige Induction Cooktop, and this is how I received it from Amazon. This is a mid-range model, and it says it has all the Indian menu options, anti-magnetic wall, timer with user preset, and automatic voltage regulator. So these are some of the basic features of this induction stove. This is the other side of the box, and on the side it has few more details on the options available to cook, like the Indian menu, automatic voltage regulator, healthy cooking, intelligent, easy to maintain, energy efficient, anti-magnetic wall, and lastly eco-friendly. So now let's open this and see. I have been using this for last 2 months for all the 3 meals, and that's why there is a slight brownish color on the cooktop from one of my vessel. I'm reviewing this after 2 months of continuous usage for all the 3 meals. This is the hot plate area, and the circle part is where you need to place your vessel. These are the options, starting from power button, saute, keep warm, heat milk, deep fry, idli. You can steam anything in idli option, curry, again to boil something like a sambar or anything, or any kind of a gravy, pressure cook, timer, and lastly dosa chapati. So one thing about this induction cooktop is that there is no heat control in this, as all these are preset options that come with a set temperature, and hence you cannot increase or decrease the temperature. However, you can increase or decrease the time of cooking. This comes with a 1 meter lengthy cable, and at the back this is the fan. So whenever the cooktop is on, the fan keeps running to keep the cooktop cold. This is how the back looks, and it also has vents given on the top and on the sides. So before getting to know how to cook in an induction cooktop, I will show the vessels that can be used on it. So when you buy any kind of non-stick cookware, you will see a plating like this on the back, which means it is induction compatible. You can use it on both regular gas stove as well as on induction. Apart from this, you can also use any kind of stainless steel vessel that has a flat base. You can even use a small vessel like this as long as the base is flat. Again, this is a stainless steel cooker with a flat base, which is induction compatible. So now let's see what are the vessels that cannot be used on an induction cooktop. Vessels that do not have a plain base. Even if the bottom of the vessel is plain, it should be of a good quality stainless steel so that the vessel doesn't smoke when it is on a high heat. Iron vessels, aluminium and copper bottom vessels, glassware. However, these days aluminium cookwares come with induction base. If so, you can use that, as long as it has a proper induction base at the bottom. And glassware like Borosil and such glass wares, which can be used directly on the gas stove, cannot be used on the induction cooktop. So now I will show you how to cook using this induction cooktop. To start with, please plug the power cable and switch it on. This is how it will blink as soon as the plug is on. To start with, I will boil the milk. Now I will press the power button and choose heat milk option. So it says 20 minutes. Although it says 20 minutes, it doesn't actually take that long for the heat to get boiled. So now you can see the timer has reduced to 13 minutes and already the milk is about to be done. So what you can do in this case is you can either reduce the timer to 7 minutes so that the stove will automatically get switched off in 7 minutes, or you can switch it off once the milk is done. And another interesting thing here is that unlike the regular gas stove, the vessel does not get heated. I can easily touch the vessel and transfer it anywhere. You wouldn't need a kitchen towel or a puckard for the same. So now I'm going to show you how to steam some idlis, which I'm going to make for the breakfast. I have placed the steamer with two plates of idli. The main power is already on. So now I will press the power button on the cooktop and choose idli. The default timer for idli is 10 minutes. You may increase or decrease the timer according to the food that you are steaming. So in a couple of minutes, you can see the water would have started to boil. You can see the steam is getting formed. Now you can see there is 4 minutes left. And this is how it is steaming. Okay, so now it's 10 minutes and it is done. So now the steamed idlis are ready to be served. Next, I'm going to make a curry, or I can call it as a kurumbu, for which I will be using 3 different options for the same dish. For this, I'm using a regular Prestige induction-based stainless steel cooker. I'm switching on the power and choosing saute mode. And I'm adding a little bit of oil into it. Before sauteing the vegetables, I actually wanted to dry roast few ingredients for the curry. So once the stove is on and when I suddenly pick up the vessel from the stove, you can see it shows EO, which means error, that the heat would automatically get cut off. And once I place the vessel back, it will continue in the same mode as it is. But now since the heat was quite a lot and I'm done with the roasting of these ingredients, I have put off the stove and I'm still continuing to add the ingredients, as this heat would be sufficient enough to roast the dry red chilies and curry leaves. So saute mode has a very high temperature, so it literally takes a very few seconds for heating. So in the same vessel, I'm going to do tadka and sort the veggies. So since it is already started to splutter, I'm quickly shifting it to the keep warm option, as I don't want the mustard seeds and dry red chilies to get burnt in the saute mode. So I'm adding the veggies and giving it the mix. And you can see the light on the keep warm option is on. So keep warm is like similar to the sim option that we use on a regular gas stove. Or if you want more heat and you feel that keep warm option is not okay, then you can anytime shift to any other option, maybe saute option or any other option that you would want. So I'm adding some basic ingredients to this, like salt and turmeric. And I'm going to pressure cook this. I'm adding some tamarind water to this, giving it a mix and putting the lid on for pressure cooking. I have chosen the pressure cook option. So it is hardly like 30-40 seconds, and you can see the pressure indicator in my cooker is, so it's really quick. It hardly takes few seconds for the pressure to get created. In some case, it quickly gives whistles, but however, the food may not have got fully cooked inside. So in those cases, after like one or two whistles, you can shift it to the keep warm mode, similar to the way we simmer the gas stove, and you know, keep it for like 5 or 10 minutes as it may be required. Next, I'm going to boil some pasta for my son, for which I'm using a Hawkins saucepan with an induction base. I'm adding the pasta along with the required amount of water, and I'm switching on the power, and I'm using the idli mode as I want the pasta to boil. You can also use curry mode or pressure cooker mode. I'm adding some salt and also some oil to it. So I choose idli mode. Any mode will start, boiling the pasta, like pressure cook mode or curry mode. But idli mode is best for me. You can see within 2 minutes how nicely the water is boiling. So 10 minutes is over, but I feel it requires a couple of minutes more to get cooked well. So what you can do is either you can use the idli mode again for 5 more minutes, or you may also use the keep warm option for 5 minutes and put the lid on. Either way should be okay. So now I have put it in keep warm mode. The heat is on and goes down. So what happens in keep warm is there is heat and the heat goes down. And again the heat comes up and again the heat goes down. So the heat does not remain continuous. It heats up, it goes down. It heats up, it goes down. So that's how the keep warm mode works. So now in the same saucepan, I have added some butter. I'm keeping this in keep warm mode as I don't want the butter to get burnt. I'm adding the required sauces and the seasonings, giving it a mix. And I'm adding the boiled pasta to this, giving it a good mix. If you notice, I'm continuously cooking in the keep warm mode as I want that mild heat only. Finally, adding some cheese, mixing it well, and I'm going to put the lid on for the cheese to melt well. So it will continue in keep warm mode, and once the cheese has got completely melted, the pasta is done and you can put off the stove. So now we'll continue with the curry. The steam has got released from the cooker and the vegetables are boiled well. To this I am going to add some ground coconut paste, and I'm choosing power on and curry option. So basically for this recipe I used saute mode for the tadka and to saute the veggies. Then I used pressure cooker mode to pressure cook the vegetables, and I'm now using the curry mode to boil the gravy. So for the same recipe I have used three different options. So now I'm using this saute pan to stir fry the veggies. So I'm using this cut veggies, which is lady's finger and brinjal for the stir fry. So I have chosen power on and saute mode. I'm adding some oil to the pan. The oil would get instantly heated in the saute mode. So I'm adding the cut veggies to it. Also adding the basic ingredients like turmeric, salt and chili powder, and giving it a good mix. So an important tip here is that if you continue to cook in the saute mode, then the veggies would get burnt. So once the basic sauteing is done, you can shift it to the keep warm mode, as the veggies need to get cooked properly and stir fried properly without getting burnt. So after 20 minutes in keep warm mode, the bhindi and the brinjal, they are stir fried well. So that's it. So finally, I'm going to show the dosa chapati option, for which I'm using a non-stick tawa. So put the tawa on the cooktop, power on, and select dosa chapati option. It shows DC there. DC means dosa chapati. So in this mode, unlike other modes, you don't have to shift to keep warm mode multiple times. You can continuously cook in this particular mode for dosa or chapati. The heat would remain consistent throughout. So as soon as you put the tawa on the induction stove and choose DC mode, so it is going to get instantly heated in like few seconds, and you can start doing the dosa immediately, unlike the regular gas stove. So especially making dosa on the regular gas stove takes more time, and I find this one pretty quick. And you can see that it has already become brown, and I have already flipped it to the other side. So that's all. The dosa is done. Same way you can do chapati as well.
So that's all about the Prestige Induction Cooktop, guys. I hope you found this video to be useful. If yes, please hit a like, share it with your friends and family, and don't forget to subscribe to Sizzling Vidya YouTube channel. Follow me on Facebook and Instagram, and I'll see you all in the next video. Until then, thanks for watching, and bye bye.